What's up, guys? I'm KBHD here. And the future is clearly this bezel-less thing that we're moving towards. I don't know if we all want it to go that way. I don't know if that's everyone's future, but that's the direction we're headed. So we've talked about the notch up at the top of these bezel-less phones and the struggle for getting rid of the notch and all of that, and there's a whole separate video for it. But what about the bottom half? What about the other half of this bezel-less phone struggle? It seems like every time a phone comes out that claims to be bezel-less or closer to it, there's still this little chin at the bottom half of the screen, like every single time. And there's also usually comments complaining that there's this little chin. Let's talk about that. Now, don't get me wrong, this is still way better than the months ago that this phone came out and we felt it was totally normal, because it was. But things have changed a lot and we have major goals of removing the bezels from the top and the bottom. But then a couple months ago, we got that Vivo Apex concept phone that represents like pretty much the best of what technology will let us make. Not necessarily mass produced, but the best we can make right now. And that, of course, had a very, very small chin at the bottom. It had that full screen display, corner to corner, the fingerprint sensor underneath the glass, the front-facing camera that retracts into the top of the phone, this motorized solution to not having a notch. It's a head turner and it's pretty sweet and it's futuristic looking as a finished result. But of course, like we mentioned, that was a concept phone, and then Vivo came out with this actual phone that they're gonna sell a couple weeks later, and it has a lot of those same technologies, the full screen display, the pop-up camera, the underglass fingerprint reader, but it has this little chin at the bottom. And yes, there were plenty of people who felt the need to comment about the fact that it's not fully bezel-less because of that little chin. A lot of those comments were mainly just saying, you know what, you shouldn't call it truly bezel-less if it has that tiny chin at the bottom still. Sure, I get that. But of course, a lot of people were also just wondering, why? Why? Every time we get one of these phones that's almost bezel-less, it always seems to have some sort of chin at the bottom of some varying size. Why don't we have fully bezel-less yet? So this is all of that in one place, in one video. This is why phones have chins in 2018. So it has to do with the way displays work. Fundamentally, every single smartphone display, you know, LCD, OLED, whatever it is, needs a thin ribbon strip for connecting it to the device's motherboard. So phones have them, tablets have them, laptops have them, but they're smallest in phones and it's just this pretty thin piece, but it's there since every display needs to connect to the motherboard. So you gotta put this piece somewhere, you gotta connect it somewhere, generally at the top or the bottom. It would be weird to have like a side bezel. So they usually pick the bottom because it just looks more modern this way. So these new phones getting smaller and smaller bottom bezels is just a function of physically us pushing that, shoving that connector closer and closer to the edge of the body of the phone as possible. But we still don't have truly bezel-less phones because that connector, that edge connector to connect to the motherboard just has to go somewhere. Now, the one exception to this is the iPhone X actually does this a bit differently. And you might have thought about this, but iPhone X may be the only phone I can say kind of has no significant chin. It's still a small border, but it's as thin as the side bezels on this phone and thinner than any other chin. So how did Apple do this? So Apple is actually, with the OLED display, folding the bottom of the OLED back underneath itself into the phone again and connecting it underneath. So the display part itself essentially continues down all the way into the bottom of the phone, but there's actually more display folding back into your iPhone X that you never see. That's how they've minimized their chin. So the technology there is actually really impressive, and obviously the final results turned out pretty great. So the question naturally is, why isn't everyone doing this? A couple reasons, actually. Number one, it's thicker. Minor point, obviously, but yes, to curve that part around and fold it under itself, it will make your display assembly and eventually your whole phone a bit thicker. But number two, it's much more expensive. Getting that high-end, flexible OLED panel to do that and the engineering to do it well over and over for millions and millions of phones, this screen is a big reason why the iPhone X costs $1,000. It has a lot of the same internals as iPhone 8, same software, same battery, same processor, but it's that display that's really expensive. And then on top of that, number three, it's just really, really hard. Obviously, Apple's engineers have been working a long time on this, and the reason it looks so good is because of that hard work. So copying it isn't just a matter of, oh, I'll also fold our OLED display underneath the glass. That's a whole process that's taken a long time to get to look this good, and I'm sure others are working on it now, but that's the reason we don't see others doing it immediately. I've also heard people say Apple patented this process. I'm not so sure about that one. I haven't seen or found any patents that lock down Apple being the only one to do this, but they're the only ones to do it so far. But honestly, that's the real reason, I think, to get excited about flexible OLED displays. It's not really so much for the crazy foldable phones that we're seeing in these concepts. I don't know how many people really want that. It seems cool in concept, but using it is very different. You want those flexible OLED displays to be good, and you want Samsung to keep working on stuff like that so we can get more high volume folding and permanently fixing displays in these weird positions. That's what makes them interesting. Basically, it turns out one of the best properties of a flexible OLED display is being able to fold underneath itself and make a bezel-less corner. So all right, hopefully that all makes sense. I think we all learned something. I know I did. Basically, we know why we have bezels. At the bottom, the chin is literally right now a physical necessity because of that connector. But hopefully, we get these high-quality flexible OLED displays in mass soon so everyone can do that awesome fold and not have a chin. And we can do that whole bezel-less thing we're all looking forward to. Also, RIP front-facing speakers. Either way, that's been it. Thanks for watching. Talk to you in the next one. Peace.